Hi, I'm from Studio SOS PTA Limited. Studio SOS PTA Limited is a Singapore-based company, and my name is Raj Saini. We are into event management and digital marketing, and we are in this field since 1994. That's almost 25 years now. We have done more than 10,000 events in around 32 countries, and we manage a lot of big brands. Like we manage Transport Minister of Canada, the ruling party of India, and a lot of celebrities in digital marketing also. So we know a lot about internet, and we are into creating brands using the internet. But today, I will not be presenting for the event management or the digital marketing. In USA, we are known as Studio SOS LLC. In Canada, we are Studio SOS Limited. UK, Malaysia, India. We are in 6 countries. We are a multinational, we are established, and we are already working and operational. Today I will be presenting about a concept called MallSOS.com. MallSOS is a unique concept, and it's the first of its kind in the world. I'll again repeat this line. It's the first of its kind in the world. We are like going into amalgamation of virtual and real world. See the concept, I'll just brief you before I can go further on. See what happens is, when we go on the e-commerce website, in Singapore itself, there must be like a few around 10,000 plus e-commerce websites. And the market of e-commerce in Singapore itself is pegged as around 4,500 billion Singapore dollars. Worldwide is going into many trillion dollars. But still, when we talk about e-commerce websites, we can barely talk about few of them, like Amazon, maybe Lazada, Qoo10. But there is always a problem, except few established names, we are just spending $5, $10, $20 or $50, $100 tickets. Rest of the places we don't order much of the things, especially like clothes. Because what we always believe that what is we see is virtual pictures and into physical sampling are two different things. When the product will come, it looks only fancy in the photographs and is actually not. Second thing, when it comes to like multi or bigger ticket sizes, something like $5,000, $10,000, we will never swipe our cards. We will always prefer that we go to the stores, because that will be the way we are much more sure that what we are ordering is what we will get. We want to see it, touch it, feel it. And what we have done is, first time what we are opening is these experience stores. We call them experience stores. And they are the first of its kind where you can come, see the sample, touch and feel. You can discuss with us what kind of cloth it is, what are the color choices, what is the things. And just with that, we have two models, retail and wholesale. It's a different pricing, different kind of model. And besides that, the biggest thing we deliver out there is that local guarantee that your payment is safe. If the product is not of the quality, we are always here because that store is there. Safety of the payment, because you are using the local channels. You are not swiping your card into US or anywhere else. You are doing it like an example in Singapore itself. That's a unique element of it. And what you aspire is available with us. What I mean with this, I'll just continue on the further. Our first store is already operational in Sultan Plaza at Jalan Sultan. That's already operational. That, like what we are not talking about only concept, it's already in the place and it's operational. Second store, the work is already in progress. We are opening in April in Canada, Toronto. That's the second store we are already coming up. Two more in USA, that's New York, UK in London. We have already identified the locations. That means two more are coming up within the first 6 months of this year. Now the biggest question is, now everybody will have to think what we sell. See, what we are selling is a bigger wide range, wellness products. As for the wellness products, I will say is like Vastu, Feng Shui, healing, those kind of things. other day also I gave this example out here itself, I'll repeat that example. What happens is, when we see organic products, leave alone Singapore, Singapore is still a safer destination. If we go towards India, almost 90% of the products which are marked organic are fake. When we talk about diamonds, which are like, now I'll give you Singapore example, you see 20% discount, 30% discount on the shops. It's a very common thing to see in Singapore. You know, 90% of the diamonds are made in the lab, not the real diamonds. If you will talk about healing products, these stone, that stone, a lot of shops are carrying it. I would say almost 60% of them are fake, made in the labs. In China, every stone which is for use for healing is fake. Almost every. Because China don't have quarries for those kind of stones. So what we are providing is, with the local guarantee, the real products from where they are coming. Second, I will say about the garments. Other day I was again giving the example. I think I have time for that. Other day I went to a store called Giordano. Today I'm wearing that shirt. I bought 6 shirts in one go. Normally I'm not a person who will buy 6 in one go. It's one a month. But the reason was, they were selling this for $15. And this was priced at $72 with a tag on it. Pure linen shirt, everything, $72. The problem is, if you store a thing and if the inventory will not move, you have to clear it either at a loss or at the cost price. And to store the inventory and invest into it, you need to inflate the price to cover up that cost elements of those things. And the NTUC, which is supposed to be non-profitable organization, the profit margin they work on is close to 80 to 100% on each product, each. That includes vegetables, that includes rice. Rice is supposed to be the staple diet, but still NTUC keeps 100% margin on it.
You all know.
So that's a fact. Even like we talk about Walmart is too cheap, Giant is too cheap. Their profit margin is as high as 80% to 200%. So what happens is, when we are like scaling down on these things, and we are like working on this newer model, we don't have the inventory cost with us. And what happens is, like, why Giordano, which I was giving you an example, why sold it so cheap? Because they need to remove the old goods so that they can get the new designs in. And when we go to shop, after 1 year also, we see almost 80% of the products of the, with the old design. Because they are not able to move the stock up. So what we are saying is, we'll get you the latest design within 24 to 48 hours, and you can see the sample within that much time, and you can touch, feel things. Same is about the hotel restaurant equipment. See, the only difference between a food court stall and a fine dine restaurant is the way they serve it. And in Singapore, I can in total count everything around 20 shops which are selling those kind of products. Only 20 shops. And you know how many restaurants we have in Singapore? See, everybody knows about it. So only 20 shops catering or get delivering to them. Obviously, how big? So what is my example by this is that we are choosing the products which you aspire is not easily available. And either if it's available, it's because of the high price, because people are stocking it. Land cost is too high in Singapore and other places. That cost will go, then manpower cost, then so many other costs which add on, which increases the cost of the product. Now I'll come on to the profitability, what I was just talking about it. See, we are sourcing the products directly from the manufacturer, so which cuts down the chain of wholesaler, retailer, supplier, this, that, so many of it. Second thing is, we are just looking at the target of 1 million SGD for 209 for each store. See, Singapore, we have started the first. That's the smallest market. And obviously, we'll be able to reach up there. And US is the biggest market. By the time the year will end, we'll be able to reach on this target very easily. Our general profitability percentage is only 15 to 35%. So we'll be literally killing the market. I'll just tell you, we are like selling one Indian dress at the price of $42. That same dress is priced at around $105 at the ticker. So that's the kind of margin difference we are working on. Because we are sourcing directly from the manufacturers. We don't have overhead cost because we don't have security systems, cash systems, manpower to show the products, big showrooms, stocking cost, capital investments. So we have cut down everything out of it. But still we are giving you the experience of the real store with the e-commerce mixed to it. This operational cost is assessed at 4 to 5% variable, estimated at the target sale. Target sale is 1 million. I'll just put you this way, that our operation cost is so low, in just 1.5 months of our operation, we are already in profits. We have already done around a 50,000 worth of sale of our products within 1.5 months. And we are already in profits. So our break-even level is so low that it's amazingly easy to go into profit levels. This is what we propose. We have put 10% of equity on alternate funding model. It's a new model what we are working. I will put it this way, that as our concept is new, even our funding model is a new model, which generally most people are not using it. What we are saying is 500,000 SGD we'll be raising for 10% equity based on the valuation of 5 million SGD. See, the question is this valuation when we are talking. We have each and every report to back it. Because this is not just a concept. This is the real project where the cost elements are clearly defined with the clear projections and the clear profitability which we are already achieving. I'm a chartered accountant, Singapore chartered accountant. I'll put this thing again. And I understand what we are talking about numbers out here. What we are saying is 100,000 shares of 5 SGD each. Minimum investment by any individual or corporate is as low as $5. You can just give us $5 and you are still part of the concept and we will give you the complete backing to it. What we are saying is investment, even $5 or even 500,000, it's totally non-refundable and will drive from profit will be derived only from the dividends or appreciation from the equity value. So what we are not giving you any fake promises that I'll give you 10% return, 20% return. Being a chartered accountant, I find it quite funny and different when people say I'll give you 10% return. Because it's a very simple thing. If you have a backup plan proper, banks are always there to support you. You are asking for $100,000. Trust me, anybody who's got a good credit limit, they will have credit cards in their pocket with more than that limit. If they want only $100,000, they can swipe their card and rotate that fund. Obviously, $100,000 they will not be using in one day. They can use $10,000 one day, $10,000 one day. And obviously, 10% return, man, that means they'll be earning up in 1 year. They can just pay their credit card. So it looks like fake promises and bigger pictures, but we are not giving you any fake picture out here. Again, I have seen so many presentations out here, other places also. What happens is, in Singapore law says, maximum 50 shareholders in a private limited company.
Yeah.
How can I have 1,000 shareholders? How can I have like 10,000 shareholders? That's the kind of promises people who are looking for seed funding or angels or anybody. That's the kind of promises we give. But we are not giving you any fake promises. That we are saying your investment will be secured against 10% equity. What we are doing is we are converting them into 10 parts, equity, 1% each, and we are securing your investment, for which we'll have the proper contract, and you can trade your investment internally, privately, because we are not public limited. You cannot go on the stock exchange, but that's the way you can do. Again, for whatever I've spoken, if anybody is keen to see the numbers, to see the booklets, the project reports with the future projections, what kind of investments we have done, what are the products we have, you are free to come at this address where our first shop is already operational. That's my number. You can WhatsApp me, you can call me if anybody needs more details about it. That's all I can just say about it. Thank you.